Hello students, welcome to the next lecture on the statistics subject. Today we are talking about the analysis of the variance. It is called as the ANOVA. AN is represent for the analysis, O for the of, and VA for the variance. So in this presentation or in this lecture, we will try to cover these five basic concepts are there. That is, we will discuss about what is the ANOVA, okay, and what is the basic concept behind it. Why we need this ANOVA if so far we have read the Z test, T test and all other parameters are there. And then after studying about the ANOVA need, we will try to study the one-way classification or one-way ANOVA. It is also known as the one-way ANOVA. And I just discuss in this presentation, there are the three methods for solving a single problem. So I just present you three methods for solving this one-way ANOVA table. And some examples are there to demonstrate them. So I just quickly recall that what we studied in the last lectures, that is in the student T test, we have studied the student T test where we have analyzed whether there is any significant difference between the two sample means or the one sample mean. Okay, and this is the formula for that two sample mean. Here X is my one sample, X bar is the mean of the first sample, Y bar is the mean of the second sample, and this, what is the D represent that, if you remember that, that is the difference between the population mean is how significant they are be. Okay, and this H1 is called as the alternative, and it is depending upon that whether it is one tail or the two tail is greater than, less than or not equal to B. Okay, and S is called as the pooled variance B, or called as the unbiased variance B. Now the question here, remember that whenever we are talking about the student T test, we are talking about the two samples B. Okay, that is mu1 and the mu2 are there. Now the first question arises is that which test should we use to determine whether there is any significant difference when we consider the three or more. If we have considered one sample, then we know that is a one sample t test we can applicable. If there is a two sample, then we can apply the student t test, difference between the samples. But what about the three or more than three groups are there, then which test we can use? Okay, so the answer will be ANOVA. Okay, so ANOVA is used to compare the statistical difference with the three or more independent groups are there. Okay, now second question arises is why we need them. Okay, if we already have a student T test, then why we need a three sample or three way or ANOVA is there? So the answer is quite obvious, because for example, if we are comparing the three different means are there, means if I just consider the three samples, this is my sample A, this is sample B and C, then what is my H0? So in the t-test, what we have, that is a comparing of the two samples at a time B. So my H0 will be either of this for the first case 1 and 2, A and B, either 2 and 3, it must be a 0, there is no significant difference H0, okay, or the third way is I can consider this B. Okay, so if you want to, instead of using the ANOVA, you can utilize this also. But in case of the three sample, you have to test t-test in a three manners. That is, you have to apply the t-test three times. Okay, and then check whether there is any significant difference or not, whether H0 is accepted or rejected in each of the cases. That is, firstly, experiment you conducted for this hypothesis, second time again conducted for this, and third time for this. Okay, this is for the three case, but it's very easy. But when you consider the four groups are there, means instead of this is 1, 2, 3, and 4, then you need a four test are there. Instead of the these three, you consider the four test. While for the five groups, it consisting of the 10 test. 10 test means you have to apply the t-test 10 times. And if you consider the six groups, then since the t-test consider two samples at a time, so how many ways are there? 6C2. So it means when the sample size are increasing, then the number of ways that t-test are also increased very much. So the computational complexity as well as the time consuming is very high. So in order to resolve this, there is a one ANOVA, there is a one term that is ANOVA, is designed by the R.F. Fisher in 1920. And it is also known as F-test. F is called as the variance. Okay, F is called as the variance test, which is based on the F distribution. And what is the role of this ANOVA is to compare the means and check whether there is any significant difference between them or not. So, but the thing is that before understanding what is the ANOVA, we just define some basic terms. That is the experimental units, factor, level and treatment. So instead of reading this, I just explain these terms with the help of the example so that you can easily understand. So look at that, this example. A group of the people is randomly divided into the experimental and the control groups. So it means I have considered this certain peoples and I just discretize this in terms of the experimental or the control group. So those people who are belonging to the control groups is given an aptitude test after eating a full breakfast. Okay. So, and the other experimental groups is given the same test without eating any the breakfast. Okay. So what are the factors? What are the levels? What are the treatments in the experiments are there? So now I just apply this one. So I hope you can easily understand this. So what is the experiment? Experimental means the object on which the measurement is taken. So look at that. The object on which the measurement is taken. So in this example, on what objects are there? That is the number of the peoples. Okay. So the experimental units are the number of the peoples on which the experiment or the responses are measured. Okay. Second is factors. That is the most important thing is the ANOVA. Okay. So what is the factor is the independent variable whose values are controlled or varied. Remember these two lines are there, whether they are controlled or the varied by the experimenter. Experimental means this. Okay. So in this example, means factors are those independent variables whose values are controlled or varied by the peoples. So how the peoples are varied? That is based on the meals. That is either they have taken the breakfast or not. So factors are related to my meal. Okay. And this meal, how many types are meals? Either they have taken the breakfast or no breakfast. It means they have the two levels. So look at the definition of the level is. Level is the intensity setting of the factor. Okay. So intensity means that is a measurement. So how you measure this meal are either a breakfast or a no breakfast. And the last definition is the treatment. That is a combination of the factor levels. Factors and level. In this example, how many factors are there? There is only one factor. And how many meals are there? There are two meals. Okay, so there are the factors, one factor, and there are the two meals. And this example 23 means I have considered the peoples. Okay, out of those people, I have this one sample with breakfast, and this is the second sample with the no breakfast. So I just consider one people from this group who have taken the breakfast and noted down their reading. Okay, and the reading is 23. Assume that. Okay. Similarly, I just consider second sample, second element or second people from this group that is who taken the breakfast and the reading is 25 and so on. Similarly, for this, I have taken this and now the task is to check whether there is any significant difference between all those peoples which have taken the breakfast or not. Okay. So remember, here is how many factors are there. There is only one factor. Okay. Consider the second example so that you can easily compare them. Suppose that in the experimental, in the example one that is in the previous one, I just select randomly the 20 men and the 20 women. In the previous example, we said is we select the number of the people. How many number of people? It is not given. Now, in this case, it is given that there are the 20 men and the 20 women are there. And these two groups, that is the men and the women, are randomly divided into the 10 each for the experimentals. Okay, these are the experimental and these are the controllers. Then what are the factors and so on. Again, what is the experimental is number of the peoples remain the same. But what is the factors? Peoples, now what kind of the peoples are there? Now the peoples are either the men and either men or the women are there. So it means these are my, so what is the, represent that men or women? These are represent my gender. Okay, so here there are the two factors. One is the gender and what about this is breakfast or no breakfast, that is a meal. Okay, so look at that. In the last example, there is only the one factor. Now here there is called as the two factors. And each gender is representing again as a two levels or the two groups, men and women, and meals are the breakfast and no breakfast. So look at that. If I just represent factor here, meal, one factor meal without breakfast and with breakfast, while the second is the gender here, this is a meal, a men and the women. So how many combinations are there? So either the men without breakfast, men without breakfast, men with breakfast and so on. So total four combinations are there and these combinations are called as the treatment. So I hope you may able to recognize with the example 1 and 2. If you are not recognized, look at the back example 1 and try to read it again. So in this case, we have in the last two examples, that is in the first example, we have the factor 1, while in this case, there are the factor 2. Factor 2 means there are two independent ones. One is the gender, second is the meal. Okay, look at one more example. So consider some experimental study which are based on the teaching methods to examine the marks of the students. Okay, and what techniques we have used is either the online mode teaching or the offline mode or the video lecture based. Okay, so what are the factor is and the, what is the experiment is examination of the marks based on the students on the students. So what is the factor is that is the independent variable is teaching method. What are the teaching methods? That is either the online, offline or the video based. So if I just consider a class and few of the students who have taken the learning based on the online mode, then I got a marks of 12, 34 and so on. Similarly for the offline this and then on the video based this. Then my task and look at that. This is my sample 1. This is my sample 2. This is my sample 3. So more than the more than 2 samples are there. Okay. So then our task is check whether there is any significant difference between the learning methodology given by online, offline or the video based. So to solve such type of the problem, we use the ANOVA. Very firstly, you just remember that the number of the samples must be greater than of the 2. Okay. If in any problem when the sample is greater than 2, then ANOVA is applicable only. Okay, so based on this previous study, look at that. Remember that in the example 1, how many factors are there? 1 factor. Okay, while in the example number 2, okay, we have the 2 factors B, that is the gender and the men. And look at the example 3rd, that is the previous one, how many factors are there? Only 1, that is a teaching method. So based on these factors, okay, based on this independent variable, we discretize this ANOVA into the 2 parts. One is called as the one way factor, one way classification or one way level. That's the same thing. Or somebody called as a one way ANOVA. Similarly for the two way ANOVA, that is based on the two way factors are there. One way ANOVA is also called as the CRD. This is the RVD. And since the ANOVA is the analysis of the variance, so our task is to measure the amount of the variance, variability, how much changes is there. Now, what is in this lecture we were talking about only for the one way ANOVA. Okay, so what is the one way ANOVA is we have considered only the one factor, that is I just consider the group. Okay, and I consider the k samples are there. Definitely k must be greater than of the 2, means k is at least 3 are there, then only ANOVA is applicable. And some observations, so if I just consider one sample, x11 is the observation, x12 is here, and this is called as the ANOVA observations. And if I just calculate the mean of this, how many elements are there, it may be say xi of n or x1 of n. So I just calculate the mean of this is x1 bar, similarly of the second is x2 bar, similarly third is xk bar. And what is the overall mean is? Overall mean sum divided by total number is my overall mean x bar. Now the question arises is how? Okay, for example, in the same in the online learning modes are there. So there are the, instead of the k sample, there are my 3 samples are there. That is online, offline and the video based. And this is the reading of the student 1. This is the observation of the student 1 when he or she has taken the online learning. Similarly, the student 1, if he or she has taken the offline learning mode, while for the video is 23 and so on. Okay, and look at there, the number of the students taken in the offline are only 3, here 4 and 5. So it is not necessary that the number of students in each sample must be equal. So how you check, how you measure the variances are there? So look at that, variances is divided into the 3 types. One is between the groups. Second is within the group and third is a total. What is the groups? Look at group means sample. Look at in this. If I just calculate here, is there any significance? Okay, firstly, can I calculate the variance of this? These 4 numbers are there. You can easily calculate the variance. So I call as the S1. Similarly for the variance of the second S2, variance of the third S3. Okay, or in terms of the mean, if I calculate the mean of the first series is X1 bar and so on. How much x11 deviate from the x1 bar? How much x12 deviate from the x1? That is, this is my group 1 and so on. Okay, so it means if I just calculate xij minus of xi, if I just consider this, this is 2,1 with respect to 2b. So this is my variance x minus bar square. okay, this is the deviation corresponding to this one, that is within the group. Look at that, this is group 1. Now the group 2, similarly if we summation them, it means this group 1, group 2, group 3, group k, total is there. So this is within the group. Okay, so if I consider the between, look at this, first one is between. What is the meaning of between is this deviation between this, deviation between this, deviation between this. What is overall observation is this. So you have to find the deviation of this, deviation of this, and deviation of this. So what is that? Total deviation this minus what is the mean of total is this. So this is my deviation. So I just consider here. Okay, and how many elements are there? So instead of the double summation, I can consider here as a single. And with respect to j is ni. What is the ni is? Ni is number of the elements in the ith row. I just explained also in the numerical example. And what is the total is? Look at that. How many elements are there? Look at that. This. What is the total is? If I just calculate the mean of this, how many elements are there? 5, 3 and 4. Okay. That is 12 elements are there. If I just calculate the total variance, total mean, and then calculate the variance based on it, that is called as the total variance. Okay, I just come back here. So the F ratio, that is the NO wise, defined as, that is the between the groups divided by within the groups. So what are the assumption? Assumption is remain same as that of the T test, that is the samples are independent and randomly selected. Population is the normally distribution. And this is the assumption of the student T test, that is variances are same. And the last assumption, this is new assumption in the ANOVA, is variance are additive in nature. That is the total variance, this, look at what is the meaning is, this is this plus this is equal to total. That's the assumption is there. Okay, so what is the null hypothesis? Since there are the more than the two samples, so H0 is always be, there is no significant difference between them. So that is the equal. And H1 is, what is the opposite of it is, either, if I just consider three samples, this is my H0. Okay, so what is my H1 is, either this is not equal to, but this is equal to, okay, or this is equal to, but this is not equal to, or mu1 is not equal to mu3, or is equal to mu2, and all are not equal to. So these are my H0, H1. Okay, so what is the meaning of them? In each of the case, you can see that at least one group differ from their mean. Okay, so this is the basically we have tried to construct them. This is where. Okay, so look at that. I just calculate this number, this, and this is the total. This is nothing but addition of this. SS, I just calculated this and total is here. Look at that. There is no need to calculate. This is 2 divided by 1. There is this number divided by this number. I calculate here, this and so on. What is the DF is degree of freedom. SS is called as the sum of square. This is the mean sum of square. Okay. How to calculate them? We just come back again in the numerical examples. So there are the basically two ways to compute them. One is based, firstly is based on the mean. Okay, and I just discuss here. Basically this is, I just calculate. What is the meaning is? I just calculate here. Okay. So this is say number one. This say this is number A. This is number B. Say this is C. So based on this formula, I just calculate this is my A, SS sum of the square between the groups. Sum of the squares between the groups, that is A. Okay. So by using this rule, but what is the rule is X bar and so on, this is my B and this is my C. And instead of the C, you can see that this plus this also be there. But this is sometimes is very quite lengthy. So the second easiest way is that. Okay, and I just always prefer to my student is preferable this one. What is that? You have the observation, calculate the total, that is a sum, I call as a T1. Second is that T2, and the last is this. G is my grand total, that is either you can say sum of this, this is nothing but this so on up to the TK. And the step one is you have to calculate the C, that is a correction factor, G square by N, total square. Divide n, what is the n is total number of the elements in the sample, and after that what is the SS total, that is what is the SS total is, I just want to calculate this number. Okay, by this, double summation of the xij square means whatever the element is here, square of this plus square of this plus square of this plus square of this, so on, minus of c. Similarly, SS between the group is Ti square divided by Ni, and the group is subtraction between them. Okay, in order to explain it, I just quickly move on the example 1 so that I can explain how this performs then. So consider an experiment to determine the effect of the nutrition on the attention span, and group of the 15 students are considered. Okay, so this is my experiment, number of the students are there, and what is the effect is either the no breakfast, or they have taken the light breakfast, or the full breakfast, and there are some observations noted down. That is the span, that is the minutes are there. Calculate the ANOVA table for this. So firstly look at that, how many factors are there? Only one, that is the meal. Again, this is the meal. Okay, so what is that? How to perform that? Look at this is my table. I just prefer the second method. Okay, so what is that? Look at the add of them. This is the total of this. This is my 47. Total of the second row is my 70. Total of the third row is 65. Calculate the sum. This is 180. Now calculate the C. G square by N. Here the G is 182. What is the N is? How many elements are there total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 in each row. So total are my 15. Okay. Then what is the number is? This one. Then it means, now I just calculate these numbers are there. SS total, sum of the squares minus C. 8 square, first number, plus 7 square, plus 9 square, plus 13 square, plus 10 square, plus 14 square, plus, and so on. Last is plus 15 square, plus 12 square, minus C. Always remember minus C everywhere. So minus of C, it comes to be this number. Look at that. This is SS total. This is SS, sum of the square, total, and answer will be here. Okay, now look at the SS between the group, SS between the groups. So what is that? This is Ti square. What is that? T represents for my total. Total for summation means group. So what is the group is? This is my group 1, group 2 and group 3. So group 1 total is 47. 47 square. How many elements are there in 47? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here is 5. Plus, what is that? Second number is 70. Number of elements included in this? Again 5. 70 square divided by 5. Third group is 65 and so on. Minus C is again always B. So you will get 58.33, that is here. Okay. Now remaining table you can easily solve it with the simple calculator are there. So what is the degree of freedom? How many groups are there? 3. So what is the degree of freedom is 3 minus 1. Always remember that last lecture degree of freedom is N minus 1. So degree of freedom is 2. Always calculate the total. How many total elements are there? 5 plus 5 plus 5 10 15. 15 minus 1. Degree of freedom, total number of elements are 15 minus 1 is 14. Okay, so error is always this plus this is equal to 12, 14. So how, what is that number is? This plus this is there. Similarly, this plus this is equal to this. Okay, so you can easily calculate them, you can subtract them, you will calculate this. Okay, so look at that. These values are here. 2, 12, 14. Remember, this is the previous value. And this is, you can subtract them. You will get this. What is that? This 2 divided by 1. So, this 50, this number is calculated with help of 58 point this divided by 2. You will get this number. Okay, and similarly for this number is calculated by 71.2000 divided by 12. You will get this. And what is the F ratio is? F ratio is always be between divided by within. Okay. So this is MSS. So this number is calculated is 29.266 divided by 5.933. That is ratio of this. You will get this. Okay. So you divided this. So what is the degree of freedom? So now look at that. So degree of, now since is the taken of the ratio, so what is the degree of freedom of this number 29.266? 29.26 degree of freedom is 2b. So 2 comma, that is for the denominator. What is the degree of freedom for the 5.933? That is a 12. Okay, this is the way of the degree of freedom. So now level of significance 5%, it is not given. You can see this value from the F table. In the last lecture, we have seen the values for the T table. Now look at the table, T table in the any statistics book. Okay, look at the values for the F T table. Is look like this one. This is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Here is 2, here is 12. Look at this number. Okay, add the 0.05 is come to be 3.89. Either you can represent this way or you can use the subscript. That's the same thing. So now rest procedure is remain similar. This is my 3.89. This is my minus 3.89. Okay, and look at the value of the this 4.93. So where it lies there? 4.93 here. Okay, and what is the H0 is here? There are the three samples, so we assume that all are equal and H1 is at least one of them differ. At least one of them differ. So here 4 point something lies here, so it means we rejected H0 and what is that up to the 95% is confidence. So rejected H0 means H1 is accepted. It means there is a significant difference between the given samples. Okay, students. Now quickly look on these examples second. So I just considered two or three examples so that you may be able to understand the problem quickly. So look at that example second B. So again, there are some, now look at, there are the four brands are there which are randomly selected and the examiner check whether the company use all the brands and their miles are there. So their lifts are there. Test at the 1% level of significance. So I again approach the second approach. So look at the total of this. It comes to be 78. Second row, second sample total, third sample, fourth sample. G, what is G is my? This is my grand total. Okay, so grand total is my 324. So calculate the first one. C is equal to G square by. Now look at what is the N is. How many elements are there in it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so G square by N. So you will get this. So, and then you again procedure is SS total is 20 square. That is this formula is there. So 20 square plus 23 square plus 18 square plus 17 square plus 19 square plus this plus this plus this plus this and so on. Last up to 16 square. Plus 18 square minus C. Always remember minus C. Okay, minus C is my 5832. And the answer will be 82. Similarly, SS brand. Brand is my group. So what is that? 78 square. How many elements are there in? 4. So look at that. This number is 4. Second one is 87 square. What is this? Remember, this is my total. 87 square divided. How many elements are there? 5. Look at 5. Third is 93 square. How many elements are there in 93 is 5. Similarly for others, you will get 21.6. So you can substitute here. What is the degree of freedom between the brands? How many brands are there? There are the 4 brands. So 4 minus 1, 3. What is the total number of elements? Always calculate the total and the brands within. Within can calculate it with the subtraction sign. So what is the degree of freedom of the total? How many total elements are there? 18. So degree of freedom is 18 minus 1. 17. So this plus this is equal to 17. So this number is my 14. Look at that SS between the brand. SS between the brand is 21.6. SS total is 82. So the remaining is 60.4. And what is 7.2? How I calculate 7.2 is 21.6 divided by 3. Look at that. This M is my mean. Okay, SS is my sum of the square. So how you calculate the mean? Sum divided by N. Sum divided by N. So this 4.31 is calculated by 60.4 divided by 14. And this number is calculated by 7.2 divided by 4.31. Okay, and what is the degree of freedom is? So 7.2, what is the degree of freedom of the 7.2 is? Corresponding 7.2 degree of freedom is 3. And divided by 4.31, what is the degree of freedom corresponding to 4.31 is 14. Okay. This is the first method. Now look at that. In that last example as well as in this, you may analyze that it is quite lengthy, because 20 square is, we already know that 400, but 23 square, 18 square, 17 square, it is quite, calculation is very lengthy. Or even 73.8 square divided by something 87 is quite lengthy. Okay, it's not any fault is there, but it's quite lengthy. So in order to reduce this, we just try to simplify in the another way. Okay, so this is the second method. This is more easier in terms of the calculation. Calculation procedure are there. Look at that. This is my initial table. Okay, you can subtract any number from these entries. I can subtract 45 from these entries. I can subtract 42 from this entry. I can add 31 in this. You can either add, you can either subtract from these entries are there. The best way is, look at the smallest element. Smallest element is my 15. What is the largest element is 23. So choose any number between the 15 and 23 so that your calculation will be less. Okay, so choose any number between them and then subtract them. Subtract from each element. So I just consider that 20. You may choose any number. So subtract 20 from the each element so that your calculation will be less. So what is that 20? 20 minus 20 is 0. So first number is 0. 23 minus 20 is my plus 3. 18 minus 20 is my minus 2. 17 minus 20 is minus 3, and so on. Okay. Now this is my new formulated table. And the rest procedure are remain same. That is, you can add them. Okay. So what is the addition of this is minus of 2. This is minus 6, minus 9, minus 13. Okay. Plus 1, minus 1, 0. 0, minus 3, minus 4, minus 7, and so on. And look at that. This is the grand total is my minus 36. Now, based on this revised table, you can calculate C, that is G square by N. You can calculate SS of the total. What is that? This is XIJ square minus C. And you can calculate the between the groups. Here groups are called as the brand. This is same here. Okay. So what is the G is minus 36 square. Okay, so this is my minus 36 square divide N is remain 18 elements. What is XIJ? Now revised one. 0 square plus 3 square plus minus 2 whole square and so on. So this is my G. 0 square, 3 square and so on. Minus of C. Now C is again the revised one. Okay, SS brand. And you will be very surprising that the final result will remain the same. Each entry will remain the same. Okay. So look at that again. This is calculated by help of this number. And what is the degree of freedom for this is 7.2 is for the 3 and this is for my 14. Now to check whether the H0 is accepted or not. And now here is a 0.01 level of significance. So the value it is given to you. So this number is my 5.56. This is my minus 5.56. Okay. So look at that. This number is 1.67. So where 1.67 lies? 1.67 lies here. It means your H0 is accepted. It means, it doesn't mean that H0 is accepted means all the population means have same. It means we does not provide, it means we does not provide sufficient evidence. We does not provide sufficient evidence to reject H0 or to accept H0. Okay, this is a way to check whether this is accepted or not. Also, one more example. I just solved this example with the help of this method. Look at that this way. Okay, so what is that? This, I just calculate the SS between the group. So I just consider this table. Okay, so if you remember these values, so what is the SS between the groups? If you use this one, XI bar minus X bar. Okay, so if I just calculate by using this method, then the answer will remain same. So what is that? What is NI? What is I is number of the sample. So look at it. What is the N1 is number of the element in the first sample. That is 5. What is the X1 bar is? Mean of the first sample. Here is 47 is the sum. So 47 divided by 5. Okay. What is the N2 is? N2 is the number of the elements in the second sample. Again 5. x2 bar is the second sample mean, 70 divided by 5. N3 is my third sample element, 5. X3 bar is my 65 by 5. Okay. And what is my x bar is? Total mean. So what is the total sum is? 182. What is the total sum divided by total n? What is the total n is this. So after solving this, what is that? N1 is 5 into 47 by 5 minus 182 by 15 whole square plus N2. Second mean is this minus 182 by 15 square plus third N and third X bar minus 182 by 15. After solving, you will get again this number. Okay. What is the SS total? Look at this formula. What is the SS total is? This one. Okay. So I just write here. What is SS total? Instead of calculating this way, you can also use this formula to calculate. So minus capital X bar. So what is Xij is 8. So 8, first number is 8 minus, what is the total mean is? 182 divided by 15 whole square. Okay. Plus second number is 7. Look at this number is 7 minus 182 by 15 whole square. Plus third number plus so on, and the second last number is 15. X bar is my 182 by 15 plus 12 minus 182 by 15 whole scale. So after solving, you will again get 129.733. Okay, so you may analyze that, and similarly, once you get this, so you will get this one. There are the three samples, so it is 2, total 15 elements, 15 minus 1, and this you can subtract them, you will get this number. This is this divided by this, this divided by this, and if I just calculate here as A, this as B, so F ratio is A divided by B. Okay, so you may analyze that by using this method. There is a lot of calculations are there. Okay, so in the recall, what we do is I just summarize that. I just consider the three methods. Okay, what is that? First method is you calculate the sum of the squares and the sum of the totals. And this is between by using xij minus x bar square. Okay. And this is ni. You can solve this problem. First method is this. Okay. Second method is you can solve the same problem by using double summation xij square minus c. And this is ni minus c, where C is my nothing but G square by N. Okay. And the third method, this is my second method. Third method is you can firstly subtract any number from the given entries. You can subtract any number from the given elements and then apply either this or either this. Okay. So I always prefer this one so that it can be easily calculated. So I hope you can try to learn this ANOVA one-way classification, and some basic definitions are there. And finally, the rejection or acceptance decision remain the same. Okay, so whatever this is given to you, okay, or otherwise you can find from the F table, and that's on. So I hope you may enjoy this session also. If there is any doubt, you can still ask me at any time. I just give you a few problems. You can solve it. These are the some answers of these two problems are there. You can, for example, look at that this number is very large, so you can subtract any number from it. Again, these numbers are very large, so you can subtract any number from it. Look at that, if I say subtract 75, 80 and something so on, so you can solve it. Okay, so you can try to solve it. If still there is any doubt, you can ask me at any time. Best of luck, students, for this one-way classification ANOVA.